I tried to make an outline, and I'm going to share to you this outline or the structure, because by doing so, you will be able to understand what Gripaldo is saying in this article as a contribution to the discourse on Filipino philosophy. So now, he would say that the onslaught of Oriental and Western philosophies in the Philippines has marginalized Filipino philosophy. Now, let me ask you, what do you understand of that? For sure, you've read this, no? But the important question here is, did you understand it? Beginning with this. What do you understand of this? What does he mean by this? So what are the key terms here? What do you think is the most important term here in this slide? Ano? Tinuturo na yung philosophy sa classroom. Kaya lang, ang problema is, ang lahat ng mga tinuturo, kung hindi Western philosophies, Oriental philosophies. Got that? Sino ba yung kilala niyong Western philosopher? Obviously, hindi nawawala si Plato. Di ba? Most of the subjects are dedicated to him, his works. How about Oriental? Siguro, hindi nawawala sa discussion nyo dyan si Confucius. Oriental yan. Pero, Gripaldo is saying that lahat kasi ng mga kurso sa filosofiya dito sa Pilipinas, sa mga institusyon, gaya ng institusyon natin, mostly, ay nakasentro sa Western philosophy tsaka sa Oriental philosophy. So, in that sense, okay, this marginalizes Filipino philosophy. Kumbaga, na, siguro, sabihin natin, hindi masyado nabibigyan ng, hindi naman importansya kasi meron ng Filipino philosophy, hindi masyado nabibigyan ng priority. So that's, or in other words, konti pa lang yung nagtuturo, o kaya, o di kaya, konti pa lang yung nakakaalam. At konti pa lang yung nakakaalam ng importansya na pag-usapan ang filosofiyang Pilipino. Okay? Okay? Simple lang. Diba? Do you agree? Agree ba kayo? Agree ba mo tanan, ana? This is your first time to be in a Filipino philosophy class. Right? So, isa si Gripaldo sa nagsasabi na ang Filipino philosophy or filosofiyang Pilipino ay bago pa lang. At even to the point of saying that it has been marginalized by the teaching or perhaps the content on Western philosophy and Oriental philosophy. Yun ang ibig sabihin niya. So, there are reactions to that thesis, to that idea. What are these reactions? Pag sinabing reaction, hindi siya necessarily negative, ha? You have to be careful in understanding. You also have to understand the way of thinking of the philosopher, the way of thinking of the Filipino philosopher class. So, what's the first reaction? Ito yung tinanong ko sa inyo kanina sa quiz. Filipino philosophy in the traditional sense does not exist. Ano ibig sabihin ito? This is what he means. First, the traditional sense is based on the standard usage of historians of philosophy. Can you think of an example? Can you think of an example? Anong sabi sa article? Ano example sa article? Anong example niya dyan? Sino? Si? Based on the standard usage of historians of philosophy. Traditional sense. Pag sinabing philosophy, obviously you think of Plato. Right? Aristotle. And then you call it Greek philosophy. Tama? So, in this sense, Filipino philosophy must be an enumeration of Filipino philosophers. Right? So, he would say, the first set of Filipino philosophers, according to Gripaldo, ha, sabi niya, ito yung mga reformist, revolutionist. Did you have a course on readings in Philippine history? Still remember the lessons there? Kailaman siguro mo anin nila. Diba? Kailaman mo anin niya. Kani. Now, according to Gripaldo, itong mga to, nabasa niyo ba yung mga sinulat ng mga reformist revolutionist na ito? Siyempre, si Rizal, nabasa niyo. Itong kay Del Pilar, yung mga sinulat niya doon sa Diyaryong Tagalog, nabasa niyo? Andres Bonifacio, yung poem niya na Pag-ibig sa Tinubuang Lupa, nabasa niyo ba yun? Emilio Jacinto, yung Kartilya. According to Gripaldo, they were Enlightenment thinkers. So, in the traditional sense, yun yung Filipino, ganyan, that's how we can understand Filipino philosophy. So, their philosophizings were the offshoot of their historical colonial experience under Spain. Okay? The different Filipino cultural communities of that time, pag sinabing cultural communities, ito yung mga experience ng mga local people. We're talking about the experience of ethno-linguistic groups because they also have their own history, sense of history. That's what you call local history. Tama ba? You discussed that in your readings in Philippine history. Did you? Didn't you? So that's why Gripaldo, sabi niya dito, the different Filipino cultural communities of that time had similar experiences of human degradation, tyranny, educational deprivation, and irrationality. Okay? Ayan. So, that's how he would explain Filipino philosophy in the traditional sense. That's his reaction. To what? The first one. That's his reaction to this one. Pero, pansin nyo si Gripaldo, mayroon siyang sinasabi, tapos mayroong reaction, tapos may objection. Ganyan ang philosophy. Ang mga philosophers, kahit yung mga sinasabi nila, nagre-react sila sa mga sinasabi nila. You see how philosophers think? Like Gripaldo himself. Ganun. Kumbaga, they would offer an idea, but at the same time, they are also critical of the ideas that they offer. O, tingnan nyo dito. Di ba? Pansin nyo? O, marami pang mga ganyan. Sinasabi ko na lang sa inyo para at least hindi na kayo magulat. So in other words, ang philosophy, you really have to be critical. Hindi kay porque sinabi niya, siya mismo nagre-react sa sinabi niya. Di ba? So what's the objection? This is the objection to the first reaction, which is the traditional sense of Filipino philosophy. Alam niyo kung saan makikita to? Nasa bandang huli. Sa tingin ko, dapat i-discuss yan ni Gripaldo sa una. Ang ginawa niya kasi sa article, diniscuss niya sa baba, sa last part. So kaya ngayon, i-discuss ko sa inyo itong objection. Ano itong objection? It goes this way. What is the philosophical status of the writings of the first kind, which is the traditional sense of Filipino philosophy? Should they be included in the category Filipino philosophy? Anong sagot ni Gripaldo? The usual answer is negative. This is the reason why there are many Filipino philosophers in the Philippines against dito sa first categorization of Filipino philosophy ni Gripaldo. Okay? Kasi the traditional criterion for classification is the subject matter. Ano yung subject matter? Kung ano yung philosophical question in general. Ngayon, ang gusto kong mangyari ni Gripaldo is we should shift the criterion of classification from the original center, subject matter. Ang iyang example dyan, si Bertrand Russell. Kita mo? Tama ko, dili. Oh. To the margin or nationality of the author. So in other words, when you say Filipino philosophy in the traditional sense, then we must consider the unsa man nationality of the author. So in this way, a philosophical expository work written by a Filipino is Filipino philosophy regardless of the subject matter. The fact that it is thought of, written by a Filipino based on his nationality, kay Filipino man siya, so iyang nationality is Filipino, it is considered, can be considered under this category of or approach, the nationality. So matatawag mo niya. For example, even if for example I think, I write, or I interpret Plato or Russell or whoever philosopher I write about their works, it can be considered a Filipino philosophy. Okay? Ang second reaction naman, actually, ang second reaction dito class to tell you in advance, kaya nga naman ang giingon sa, i-clarify man niya sa ibang ano, sa ibang mga works niya. Okay? As the approach to Filipino philosophy. Ang iyang gigamit lang dire is reaction. Ang meaning ng reaction, approaches or approach in Filipino philosophy. So, ayaw lang magka confuse ha. You know kasi, ang mga Pilipino, ang mga philosophers, meron niyang sarili ring diksyonaryo. Meron din silang sariling language. So, you also have to be critical and, you know, sensitive about that. Okay? So, his second reaction, reaction to what? Reaction to this one. Ah, ay mo kalimut ha? Is that there is Filipino philosophy, if at all there is Filipino philosophy, it is in a holistic cultural sense based on Filipino languages, folk sayings, myths, and the like. In other words, it can be considered a Filipino philosophy if it is holistic or cultural sense based on Filipino languages, folk sayings, myths, and the like. Oh, alam nyo naman siguro ibig sabihin nito. Filipino languages. How many languages do we have in the Philippines? 185 living Filipino languages, including the foreign, including Tagalog, including Bisaya. Do you know any other languages, ethnolinguistic? Ikaw? Hindi. Katong ethnolinguistic, katong sa mga languages sa mga lumad? Manobo, Mandaya, ano ba? Folk sayings. Kung saan yung mga folk sayings? Ano itong mga folk sayings? Ha? Diba, diniscuss nyo to dati, yung elementary? Tsaka high school? Sige. Masa man? Myths? Ito din ano, mga alamat. Sumatawag siya na Filipino philosophy. And the like. So according to this second reaction, this is the explanation. Dapat kabulo mo, ano ba, mo tanaw sa article ba? The mistake lies in the fact that Filipino philosophy in the traditional sense does not represent the spirit of the people. The holy, ang traditional sense daw, dili siya ga, represents the spirit of the people. The holistic philosophical point of view that can only be discerned from the people's languages, folk tales, folk sayings, riddles, and the like. So in other words, murabag si Gripaldo dire, iyang gina-criticize ang traditional sense. You see how a philosopher thinks. Iyang gi-propose na traditional sense, pero at the same time, iyang pong gi-criticize based on what? Based on this approach, the cultural approach. So in that sense, he is already making a distinction. Now, we have here, according to Gripaldo, a Filipino philosopher. She actually died already. Bago lang. Kanisa, si Emerita Quito. So, Gripaldo is raising or using the point of view of Emerita Quito in order to explain the cultural approach in Filipino philosophy. Now, Emerita Quito argues that philosophy by definition is universal and hence, strictly speaking, there is no German or French or British philosophy but only German, French, or British thinkers. So, for Quito, the word box guys or spirit of the people or diwa, spirit of the people in Filipino or Tagalog is diwa. That's the vernacular term. In the Filipino language, is the most appropriate meaning of philosophy because we verily seek the spirit of the Filipino people. So for Quito, Filipino philosophy is that which, okay, is that which expresses the spirit of the people or the diwa. So, philosophizing, according to this approach, by extracting philosophical presuppositions constitutes the cultural approach, which is the second reaction. In the latter, or the cultural approach, we can affirm Filipino philosophy in the cultural sense and mention Filipino thinkers working on this approach, such as, apart from Emerita Quito, we have Leonardo Mercado and Florentino Imbreza. Napod ko yung mga articles gibutang dito sa drive na gisulat ni Mercado and Imbreza. So, Gripaldo is saying here na the type of philosophers, Filipino philosophers that we have in our country that can fall under this category of Filipino philosophy are Quito, Mercado, and Imbreza. Okay? Pero may mga objections sa approach ng ito. Merong mga objections sa approach ito to Filipino philosophy by analytic philosophers. First objection. Filipino philosophy in the cultural sense is not in keeping with standard usage in that traditional philosophy is an activity of individual persons within a given community. Articulating the philosophical problems of the times. It is an activity of groups of people, especially at the national level. Okay? So what do you understand? In other words, this is different from traditional approach in doing philosophy. Yes, yan yung objection ni Gripaldo. Number two, it is not generally true that Filipino philosophy or German-British philosophy does not represent the spirit of the people. within a temporal domain unless, of course, it is assumed that philosophy exists in a vacuum. So in other words, this objection by analytic philosophers according to Guipaldo is saying that yung traditional philosophizing is already expressing the spirit of the people. Third objection. A distinction must be made between philosophizing by reading, interpreting the spirit of the people or of the times, or offering solutions to the philosophical problems, from philosophizing by extracting the philosophical presuppositions of languages, folk tales, folk sayings, and folk sayings, etc. So meaning to say, what do you understand of that? What do you mean by this? Anyone? Philosophizing by reading, interpreting the spirit of the people of the times, from philosophizing. So, lahi daw na sila. Lahi ang, or magkaiba ang, philosophizing by reading, interpreting the spirit of the people, and philosophizing by extracting the philosophical presuppositions. So, that's an objection. Let's move on to the third approach or third reaction by Guipaldo. So for Guipaldo, we can also call it a Filipino philosophy if it constitutes the combined Filipino scholarly philosophical writings on Oriental and Western philosophy by Filipinos. So pwede rin siyang matawag na Filipino philosophy if we combine scholarly philosophical writings on Oriental and Western philosophy by Filipinos themselves. Okay? Each of these reactions, of course, needs to be clarified. So, sige. Now, the first kind for this reaction, what do you call this reaction or approach again? Unsa? National. Okay? Filipino philosophy constitutes the combined Filipino scholarly philosophical writings, Oriental Western philosophy. Anong tawag sa ano nito? Sa Filipino philosophy na approach? The constitutional or national approach. There are three kinds of this. I already asked you about this during the quiz. The first is to become a thorough scholar of any Oriental or Western philosophy such that she or he becomes an expert in it. So, matatawag din sa Filipino philosophy. Kahit pinag-aaral ka, kahit pinag-aaralan mo si Immanuel Kant, the fact that you are interpreting Immanuel Kant, it can be, and you are Filipino, your citizenship is Filipino, you are already doing Filipino philosophy. Second kind, so let me elaborate pala, she or he writes expository works whose aim is to make popular the ideas of his or her favorite philosopher or of the chosen philosophical area. So gaya ng sinabi ko kay Kant, consider niya na Filipino philosophy, kahit na si Kant ang sinusulat mo, ini-interpret mo, sinusulat mo, nire-research mo, Filipino philosophy pa rin yan. As long as the one making it or doing it is a Filipino. Second kind is to depart from just being an expert or scholar in the first kind sense, this one, but to modify those ideas. For example, si Kant, imo-modify mo yung ideas ni Kant, tapos Filipino ka. So, you cease to be a Kantian, but you become a neo-Kantian. Kasi yung new philosophy mo is based on Kant. And then, the third kind for this approach of Filipino philosophy is to look for a justification of the prevalence of these philosophical imports in Philippine schools and appropriate such foreign thoughts to the Filipino philosophical situation. So, matatawag mo din siyang Filipino philosophy of the third reaction or third approach dito sa third kind, ng third approach na yan, pag gumagamit ka ng philosophy, ina-apply mo siya sa situation ng Pilipinas or any situation. Nilolocalize mo siya ba? For example, interpreting utang na loob in terms of the Kantian autonomy of the will. In that sense, that's Filipino philosophy. Kaya nga naman, Filipino ka, nag-interpret ka, ginagamit mo yun, ina-apply mo sa situation ng context ng mga Pilipino. Ito yun. Now, the justification is basically that Filipinos are a Western-oriented people. Agree? Are we Western-oriented? Yes, because of colonialism. Because of what? Pananakop. Okay? Hindi nawawala yan sa context ng Filipino philosophy. Western-oriented kasi Western culture is was imposed on us. Who reside in Asia with Oriental Western ways. In other words, syempre, mga neighbors natin also influence us. China, Japan, and Southeast Asian countries. So in other words, we are Western-oriented because of our experience of colonization, and we also adopted our neighboring countries' cultures. So in other words, because we belong in Asia. And at the same time, we are also positioned in the age of globalization. You see how complex our experience of our society, of philosophy. So the conclusion is, or goes this way. That's why I asked this in the quiz. What does Ripaldo say about cultural heritage? So what he is saying as a way of concluding this discussion is that the acceptance of the three senses of approaches to Filipino philosophy, the traditional, cultural, and national, in other words, katong gingon niyang reaction, muto ang approaches to Filipino philosophy. Traditional, cultural, and national will certainly enrich the cultural heritage of the Filipino nation. Wala na ninyo gibutang sa inyong papel. So now, in this postmodern age of globalization, where the marginalized are coming forward, the recognition of the existence, kasi sinasabi ni Ripaldo, marginalized din ang Filipino philosophy. Okay? Pero sa panahon natin ngayon, nire-recognize na ang Filipino philosophy. Nag-uumpisa na. In fact, lumalakas siya sa Luzon. Palakasin din natin dito. Parang ganun yung ano, meron siyang ganun na ano eh, na parang, implications. Recognition of the existence of Filipino philosophy in the three senses will signal their decentering. Okay? Filipino philosophy can shift from one approach to another without any one approach claiming as dominant. Meaning to say, all of the three approaches, the reactions, the approaches, okay, they are equally valuable. Okay, they are equally valuable. So sa panahon na to karon, pwede tamayin mong Filipino philosopher if you use the traditional, cultural, and constitutional or national approaches to Filipino philosophy. So therefore, Filipino philosophy, basically, for Ripaldo, are the three approaches that he discusses in this article and in his other articles. Okay? Okay? Now, my comment on these three approaches, if I may, is that I really think that these three approaches overlap. They overlap. Muna ko napansin. Napansin ba ninyo na? Okay, for example, when he talks about the traditional way of doing philosophy, muingon siya nga, instead of the subject matter, ang ato i-consider is ang nationality. And when you also talk about nationality, di man po di mo pwede tanggalon ang cultural context. Di ba? Okay, kung mag-philosophize ang isa ka-philosopher under the cultural approach, no? Or say, no, not the cultural approach, the constitutional or the nationality approach, bisan pag mayroon ka nga, mayroon natin siya ka-philosophy, basta nagagamit mo po siya Filipino context. So in other words, in that sense, under the third kind of Filipino philosophy according to Grifaldo, mag-overlap ka po siya sa cultural approach. Kaya ang third kind, di ba, nationality man, philosophy siya, basta ang nag-philosophize is Filipino. Pero ang Filipino, kung mag-philosophize, mag-did po siya, di man po pwede nga i-separate niya ang iyang cultural experience. Kaya ang cultural experience niya, his cultural, ang cultural experience niya, ay yun yung magsisilbing content ng kanyang philosophizing. Di ba? Let's say, for example, when you talk about utang na loob, di ba? Oh, if I will think of, in the sense of the third approach to Filipino philosophy, Filipino philosophy siya, kaya Filipino man ko. Pero, at the same time, di man po na ako ma-explain ang utang na loob if it's not considering the culture of the Filipinos. Culture about what? Culture about morality. Morality of loob. Kabalo mo sa loob. Kaysa Bisaya, ang utang na loob is utang kabubuton man. Naman tayo nga ng konsepto. Nya, dili man po nato na siya ma-explain kung i-separate na to siya sa ato ang culture. Okay, basically, the origin and source of utang na loob is Filipino culture. Di ba? So for me, my comment is that kaning tulo, nag-overlap siya. That's my comment. Wala man niya yung ingon diri. Pero muna ako na-observe. So muna po na akong take sa iyahang approaches to Filipino philosophy. So in other words, dili class, pag mag-discuss ka nita, dili kay porke ni mag-discuss ko Grifaldo, ni agree ka kang Grifaldo. Dili kay porke mag-discuss ko sa iya, agree na mo sa kuha, no? Philosophy man eh. We will look at which is which. Ana, ginasa. Even the philosophers would criticize their own work. So masanay na kayo. Masanay na kayo. Do not be confused. That's part of the beauty of our course in philosophy. Shout out, shout out.